Welcome to Sun City News. I'm your host, Norma Taylor, and here are some of the stories we're covering for you this week. We have some updates from the Community Association. Reporter Joanne Hine gets all the details about the upcoming Synchronette show. And our news team was at the recent NRC meeting. Those stories and more are coming up. Sun City News starts now.
From our studios in Pinckney Hall, this is Sun City News with Norma Taylor. Entertainment news with Randy Selman. Sports with Doug Wright. And the entire Sun City News team covering your community and the South Carolina Lowcountry.
Starting Monday, February 17th, crews will begin replacing rotting wood, repainting and power washing the pergolas at Town Square near the Bocce Courts. Working hours will be from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. The Bocce Courts will remain open during this time. Please use caution around the work zones. The latest edition of the design guidelines has moved to the governing documents folder of the community library. To find the design guidelines, log into suncityhiltonhead.org. From Resident Central, scroll to the Community Library tile. Click Documents. Click Governing Documents. The design guidelines will be in this folder. Now please note that you must be logged into the website in order to access the Community Library. The online version of the Schedule of Fees and Community Rules was updated in January to reflect changes to tennis and health and wellness fees that were made after the hard copies were printed. The online version will differ from the hard copy of the Schedule of Fees that was delivered to households with the February issue of Sunstations. To read the online Schedule of Fees, log into suncityhiltonhead.org. Scroll to the Community Library tile. Select Documents, select Publications, and click on 2020 Schedule of Fees and Community Rules. Please remember that residents are not permitted to call in vehicle gate passes for commercial vendors or domestic help. Vendors who perform work at your home must have an annual decal or must buy a daily pass at the commercial gate when they arrive. Domestic help should purchase a domestics pass. Residents may request to charge a vendor's daily pass to the resident's activity card by calling 843-705-4083. Now, for more information about these events and other community activities, check your email inbox for eNews Weekly or log on to suncityhiltonhead.org. Synchronette and reporter Joanne Hines welcomes Mitzi Hawley and Deborah Murray for insight to the latest Perrysburg Water Ballet production.
Well, welcome to the very experienced producer and director of the Synchronette Annual Swim Extravaganza.
Thank you.
Good morning, JoJo. Thank you.
Well, this year's theme is feelings, and the title of the show is called Hooked on Fantastic Feelings. And what are your feelings, Mitzi, about all the new swimmers that are involved?
Oh, I'm very excited about everybody. We have six swimmers, new swimmers, in the show this year that have never performed. We have one that will not be performing this year because she has to be away. But last year after our show, we had an open house. We had a great response. We're going to do it again this year. So if you're excited to come swim with us, that would be awesome because we love teaching the new swimmers all our fun things that we play and do in the pool, and it gets exciting for us to see them get better and better.
Now, every one of the synchronettes seems to work on the show, and in the water or out of the water. What are all involved in putting the show together, Deborah?
Well, first is that we choose the theme every spring, and then we need to have choreographers, and the choreographers, after that point, we choose swimmers, and we put the show together, and we need publicity to advertise the show. We have costuming for the show. We also transform the pool into this wonderful, magical place, although this year will be Feelings Place.
Well, it sounds like you've done everything to produce another fantastic show. How do you feel about this year's show?
We feel good. Do, 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 do.
Well, thank you, gals, for your time. And we'll get back to the pool now.
Thank you.
Thanks. Well, I'm ready to make a splash.
Reporter Chris Chase talked to the new NRC chair at the recent Neighborhood Representative Council meeting.
At the heart of every neighborhood is the neighborhood rep and the alternate rep. And once a month, they meet here at the NRC with our newly appointed Tony. Now, Tony, how are you enjoying your job and what are your plans for the year?
Well, I'm loving what I'm doing. I mean, I feel like, this is probably the most important thing that we as neighborhood reps do with our neighborhoods. We need to be a point of contact with our neighbors if they have questions that relate to the entire neighborhood, not just our own personal issues, but things that affect the entire neighborhood. We're here to provide, whatever assistance we can with the assistance of the board of directors. And we're comprised in districts. There's seven districts. All the neighborhoods are comprised in seven districts. And chain of command is, the neighborhood reps, then the districts, and then the board of directors. So in other words, if there's an issue going on that the neighborhood rep cannot solve, that affects his neighborhood, then he brings it to the district level. And once he brings it to the district level, if the district can't seem to resolve it for whatever reason, then they bring it to the board of directors. Mind you that we are communicating with the board of directors on a regular basis. So in other words, we're at our resident advisory committee meetings, the district chairs have to report to the resident advisory committee the goings on at their quarterly meetings. So all in an effort to keep people informed. But insofar as upcoming this year, we have a very, very large cadre of speakers that we're going to have coming in to Pinckney Hall to inform people of new things, sometimes old things, just to bring them up to speed as to what's going on. Because we had 30 people get elected. Not all of them were brand new or this past year, but there's probably, I want to say, about 15 of them that are brand new. So, having never heard some of these things, we want to call those things to their attention. And, if they haven't been here very long, say moved in just recently over in Jasper County or on a resale even in Beaufort County or even a resale in Jasper County, they need to learn these things. So we're excited about the year, and I'm sure that it's going to be a great year for us.
Well, you are a fountain of information for us. We do appreciate it, Tony.
You're very welcome. You're very welcome.
Have a great day.
You too.
Coming up on Sun City News, Georgia Lash attended the Be Wine My Valentine event. Reporter Chris Chase attended Bon Appetit's Instant Pot Cooking Class. And we have a television review from reporter Ken Newton. So don't go away. We'll be right back after these messages. Reporter Georgia Lash covers the next in the Sommelier series in wine education.
So, Ron, what are our guests going to enjoy today?
We're going to have two sparkling wines, one true champagne, a family-owned winery that produces a Zinfandel that pairs great with chocolates and fruits, and then we're going to end up with a cream sherry.
Now, you could stop me at the sparkling, but what is this magic of chocolate being paired with wine?
It's really just like a sensory overload. Everything kind of comes together, all things good with chocolate, wine, everything that we love, and it just makes you feel good inside.
Can you make any mistakes with that pairing at all?
You can. Not so much with what we have today. Today's going to be a lot of fun.
So we can continually overload. That's good. Now, let me just ask, if you had a takeaway lesson for someone like me who buys wine by the cute label, what would be a lesson you'd like to teach from today?
Do a little bit of research as far as your what your labels say. If they say California versus, say, Paso Robles or something like that, the more words in the location tends to be the better quality.
Now, we'll have another series coming up soon. Do you have any preview for us?
I don't want to give anything away too soon. I've got to keep you in suspense.
But the secret will truly be get your tickets early.
Yeah.
Everyone is interested in instant pot cooking. Chris Chase uncovers its secrets through the Bon Appetit Club.
Now, Jane, you're the president of the Bon Appetit. What exactly is going on today?
Well, today we've got one of our special interest groups, our Instapot SIG, and they're going to show us how to demystify using the Instapot. I think a lot of people have gotten them as gifts, and they may not be quite sure how to use them and just need to know what all they can do with it.
Now, Eileen, what actually got you into Instapots?
I wanted to find better ways of cooking, a new way of cooking, whatever.
Well, everybody has Instapots now, but not everybody knows how to use them. What advice would you give for that?
You know, just dive in and do it. There are so many recipes out there now. Just dive in and go ahead and do it. That's what I did. And it's, they won't explode on you. They won't.
I was just going to say that. A lot of people are worried about that.
Explode. I had a pressure cooker way back 30 years ago. I was always afraid of it. So this won't happen. They're all electronic.
Now, Carol, you're the program chair for this. How did you think of putting this together?
Well, my co-program chair is in one of the Instapot's special interest groups. And she said that they would like to do a demonstration. So I said, well, that would be great. That would, we need something for each month for our programs, for our meetings. And so this one we thought was good because it came from our membership. And it also serves a purpose for having samples after the meeting.
Now, I'm just curious, can we get a head start on what's next month?
Yes, next month is a cookie challenge. No, I'm sorry, that's wrong. Next month, from The Grind, the coffee place in, I think it's in Bluffton, is bringing, they're going to be able to show how they roast coffee. They'll have different kinds of coffees. We'll have sample coffee of samples and cookies. And so that's what's coming up for March. And then April is our cookie competition where people in the group volunteer to make a different kind of cookie and we all vote on them.
Carol, I'll be back in April.
Reporter Ken Newton reviews the marvelous Mrs. Maisel for us.
Up until now, I've shared with you my reviews of recent movies, but today I'm heading into new territory and giving you my thoughts on an Amazon Prime television show called The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Midge Maisel, winningly played by Rachel Rosenham, is a woman who lives a sheltered life with her husband Joel, two kids, and money galore in an apartment on New York City's Upper West Side. Midge supports Joel's dream of becoming a stand-up comedian while taking her marriage and way of life for granted. Then Joel leaves Midge for his secretary and her entire world comes crashing down. Midge ends up on stage herself, an experience that inspires her to try her own hand as a stand-up. She teams up with the local dive club owner, Susie, who eventually becomes her manager. Along the way are entertaining twists and turns, including a hilarious summer vacation in the Catskill. This dramedy rated PG-13 is full of fun performance by the cast, as well as cameos by some well-known actors. I'm sure you will love the antics that happen to Midge through the show's 3 seasons. As for myself, I can't wait for season 4 to start. Enjoy The Marvelous Miss Maisel in your own living room, either through Amazon Prime streaming or on DVD. But be warned, once you start watching it, you won't be able to stop. Speaking of streaming, you probably noticed already that Prime, along with other television streaming companies, is beginning to write and produce both television series and motion pictures. In my humble opinion, these younger companies will one day take over the traditional movie companies like Columbia and Sony. Here's why. They give their subscribers immediate access to new movies in their homes, and the quality of both the movies and television shows they create is equal to or bigger to the studios. I hope you will join me as I discuss this topic more in upcoming SCTV newscast. See you then for more of my research. I'm Ken Newton, and that's my opinion.
So much more to come on Sun City News. Randy Selman checks out the happenings on Hilton Head Island in her entertainment report. Chris Chase checks in with Oliver the Wonder Dog as he grows in size and wisdom. Doug Wright has a sports report. We'll return after some messages from our sponsors. Well, it's time for entertainment. So, Randy, I hear there's great things happening over the bridge this week.
All I can tell you, Norma, is that it's worth the trip. If you have grandkids visiting this week, or if you're looking for some good entertainment yourself, check out the Hilton Head Preparatory School's production of Beauty and the Beast. Hilton Head Prep's artistic director, Patty Maurer, invites you to step into this enchanted world that has thrilled audiences in 37 countries worldwide. The stage version includes all the wonderful songs written by Alan Menken and the late Howard Ashman, along with new songs by Alan Menken and Tim Rice. Patty not only relied on her own talent as a director, she also called on professionals from Broadway to help her with the stage and costume designs. So be prepared to be wowed. This is a story that everyone knows and people of all ages love. The show is being presented at the Prep's Main Street Theater from February 19th through the 22nd at 7 p.m. and 2 p.m. matinees on February 22nd and 23rd. For tickets or more information, call 843-671-2286 or go online at hhprep.org. Tickets will also be available for purchase at the door. On Friday, February 21st, the voices of El Shaddai invite you to celebrate and honor the spiritual thread that binds the African ancestors and the Gullah of today. The voices of the Gullah culture are a precious resource in these parts. The voices began with the idea that some of the outstanding singers from Beaufort County churches would enjoy the chance to do more. From the start, the voices of El Shaddai was a kind of all-star choir, drawing to it the singers who have more joy to share than one day a week can contain. Their repertoire spans traditional spirituals and contemporary gospel. This is a great way to put the finishing touches on the month-long Gullah Festival. Admission is free for this concert, but the group would appreciate a goodwill offer. The concert begins at 7 p.m. at the Queen Chapel AME Church at 114 Beach City Road, Hilton Head. I'm Randy Selman, and that's your entertainment report. Remember, life is entertaining, so don't miss the show.
Oliver the service dog is learning and growing, and reporter Chris Chase follows his progress.
We're back for Oliver's sixth month. Now, Anne, we have your husband with us. Must be nice to have a vet in the house.
It does. It comes in handy when they're not feeling well and take care of those things and know the right medication to give him and such. So that, which is just over the counter, really. So he's learning to wait and don't when things are on the floor. That he shouldn't be picking up. Now, he's not supposed to eat off the floor, so what we've been doing is putting it in his dog dish, and so I don't want to encourage him to eat food or anything off of the floor. So what I do is I put it. Don't. Good boy. Don't. Good boy. Don't. As you can see, he's gotten that message. Mm-hmm. So.
And you can see he really wants it.
Okay.
Now, Ian, what exactly is going to happen once he leaves you?
Well, we have him for one more year. This time next year, he will be turned in for his advanced training. And during that six-month training, of course, he could be released from the program or he can continue on for the 6 months. And what they do is they build on the 30 commands that I, as the puppy raiser, have taught him, like turning off
opening the door where you press and learn how to open the door for somebody in a wheelchair, learn how to tug, take socks off. I mean, all kinds of things that they build on those 30 commands. So that's what goes on during that next 6 months.
Well, it's time for sports. And Doug, I hear you have good news about some amazing athletes.
I do indeed, Norma, and it seems like we have champions to celebrate every week. We've heard about championships in swimming and tennis recently, and Sun City can now celebrate an amazing performance by the 70s traveling softball team. This group is headed up by manager Don Winchester and plays in several regional and national tournaments outside Sun City every year. Courtney Guthrie and I caught up with Don to get the scoop on this team's latest championship campaign in Tampa, Florida.
They have a tournament of champions. They call it a world championship in Tampa every year, and it's all age divisions and skill levels, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, A, AA, AAA, majors, senior majors, whatever. We competed at the 70s AAA, and we...
Yeah, let's see that plaque.
We brought home the bling. And this ring that Courtney is flashing over here is a funny story behind it. We got these rings as part of our championship bling. We also got a jacket, and we got this plaque. We got an MVP plaque that one of our players got, and three All-Stars. About a week after we get home, I get an email from ISSA, which is International Senior Softball. Give us your team's ring sizes. World is misspelled in this ring. So they spelled it W-O-L-R-D.
Well, you can't get everything right, I guess. Sun City Softball also supports a women's traveling team called the Lady Diamonds, an unlimited by age men's team headed by Rod Norris. And don't forget opening day for the Tuesday-Thursday League is coming up quickly on March 3rd. Doug Wright, Sun City Sports.
Thanks for watching our show this week. We invite you to check out Sun City TV's weekly program schedule in Sensations Magazine. And now check highlights and alerts on Twitter at Sun City TV HHI. Also email us at suncityTVHH@gmail.com. Now to see extended coverage of your favorite news segments, tune in to Extra. Check the current Sensations Magazine for daily times. And make sure you tune in next week to find out all the news that's happening in our community. In the meantime, I hope your week is full of only good news. For Sun City News, I'm Norma Taylor, and I'll see you next week. We'll be right back.